some technical issues, we are going to go ahead and do the Q&A. So, you must have heard this phrase that color speaks all languages. And there is a very strong relationship between human emotions and color. So, we will learn more about it. And doing the Q&A first, the best part is, you all will have more questions to the filmmaker. So now I would like to welcome upon stage my friend and the very talented Sunayana Kachroo. Sunayana is a poet, a film writer, lyricist and a producer. She was born and brought up in Kashmir, but she currently resides in Boston with a family. Sunayana has won many accolades and awards and worked with renowned filmmakers in Bollywood. To learn more about her work and to contact her, you can visit sunayanakachroo.com. And what can I say about the filmmaker? A humble human being, celebrity chef Vikas Khanna is a 5-star Michelin star. Vikas Khanna has hosted at his restaurants President Obama, several prime ministers, in addition to prominent world leaders. Recently, he was awarded as the 5th best chef in the world. Please welcome on stage Sunayana Kachroo and Vikas Khanna.
See, you will, of course, we will see the movie, but how often will you get time with a film? So let's have fun. Right? Agree? I think there is a blessing in this problem. Okay? Alright. So it also gives you, I think once you know the mind of a filmmaker, you see film in a very different perspective. This is really an awesome opportunity. Alright? Welcome, Vikas. So I think Priya has, you all know, you can Google him and you know everything about him. So I was just trying to think, what can I ask someone who is so celebrated and, you know, as you recently got an award also, the 5th most popular and, you know, chef in the world. Yeah, I think that is very wonderful. His book, I'm a writer, so I was amazed to hear that his book, Utsav, was released in Cannes Film Festival. It's a documentary based on his life and his journey from Amritsar to America, titled Buried Seas. So from cooking for the likes of Obama, Dalai Lama, Queen and President Modi, to receiving so many awards, you have made kindness and humility cool, and that makes you very hot as well. Because it would be very easy to sit on your accolades and actually just do what you've been doing and successful in that. But here we are today, talking to you as the director of a feature film. So what I would like to know, and probably it's a repetitive question, but it intrigues everyone, is that what and how did a chef who's so celebrated and well known in the world, well accomplished, how did he transition into a filmmaker?
Everyone, I think one thing I learned, when you are born and raised in a poor family, you need to find ways to celebrate. You need to find, our cousins and everyone was very rich, very talented, they used to drink Coke. We'd never seen Coke. So, like, you know, that was, my grandmother said, you know, you have to find a Nirvana moment. I love that. Nirvana moment is when everything is falling apart. You can find this stroke of genius in the universe. Like what just happened now. If it was someone else, they'll freak out, they'll do this. Because I know this movie was also born out of Nirvana moment. If Rumi said once, though most of his quotes have been bastardized, Rumi said that only in a heart where the window is open, the light will enter. I totally agree on that. Because a lot of us are accomplished, we are comfortable, we live in the first world. For many of the people, on 6-7 billion people on the planet, we are the privileged ones who are living in America. But it doesn't make me happy. It doesn't. Somehow the comforts and all those things, I feel that there's something else which I can do more in my life. And that can only happen if I keep my heart open. And I was in Vrindavan, I was shooting for that book Utsav. And we were photographing at Banke Bihari temple in Vrindavan, which is very known for Krishna's mythology. And as we were shooting, so after we got the beautiful shot of people dancing in colors, and I was enamored by the beauty and majestic temple, and you know, with this splash colors from the terraces and flowers, and beautiful, like it's Holi, for the festival of Holi. And as I walked out, there were hundreds of widows in white clothes standing outside. And you know, the guy who was very rich behind me, he said that, oh, I'm saying rich because that was his designation. Literally, he kept telling me, you have no idea how rich I am. I'm like, okay, you have no idea, can't drive. And as we were walking, he told me something very strange. He said, don't look on the left. These widows bring bad luck. Suddenly struck me, something took me back to my hometown when I saw the widows being punished all their lives. In my neighborhood, in my own families, I've seen that. They were never allowed to be part of festivals, weddings, childbirths. They were totally discarded from the society. Something happened to me that one moment. And as I'm walking, I'm confused that this still happens and exists. You know, I'm the one, privileged one, living in America. I had a dream that once in my lifetime, being a brown guy, I'm going to get a Michelin star. So I was okay with what I had, you know. And suddenly I looked towards the left, because everybody said, don't look towards the left. That's going to bring you bad luck. And I looked towards the west. There was a huge drain, very stinky drain. And this woman is standing behind the drain and next to the wall. That was my nirvana moment. Somehow I felt she made me richer. My English vocabulary is coming to an end, so I can shift between Hindi and English now. Okay, so I felt that that was my nirvana moment. When somebody I was asked not to look at, and I remember she had, and my brain is because I've been cooking for almost 30 years, I'm extremely visual. I can smell something and I can tell you how it was made and I can see something. I'm not being arrogant, it's a small gift, which is also my curse. And as she bowed, she did this to me, she kept her right hand, like left hand on her heart, and she blessed me with her right hand and did this so that nobody sees her, that she's blessing me. Because people will abuse her. Somebody thanked me for just looking. Like how generous that person must be. When everyone is hating you and people are just waiting for you to die, but someone just looks at you and you are so thankful, you bless that guy. But that woman didn't think that she's going to make indebt me. I felt I was under debt. All these years I was under debt till I put this movie out. I returned my debt. I never felt that somebody would gift me so much. And you know, life is very strange. When you are poor, nobody gives you anything. But when you're so rich, everybody wants to give you free food. It's like such a strange thing in life that now everybody, no, we can't take money from you. I said, my grandmom told me that you can't take anything for free because you're disrespecting Mahanapurna as the goddess of food. And but I have to fight now. But I think that moment was very powerful. I wrote a novel called Colorless, short story, never published. Novel, Colorless, never got published. Everybody said, you should be writing only cookbooks. You are a chef, and that is how you will die, being a chef. I'm like, I disagree. I'm going to die the way I want to die. And I'm going to die what I want to be known to die. And I don't care about what you think about me. So nothing was working. My regular life is quite tough, however calm I look. It's very tough when you're running Michelin level restaurants, you're under microscopes, you're running restaurants across the continents, you're doing television shows, which is supposed to be having a viewership of American population. And you're doing some of the TV shows which are groundbreaking and crazy life. And I have committed to write 5 books every year. It's not easy. My books are world class. And I can say that with conviction. Because someone told me that brown people books should not, they shouldn't charge more than a dollar. I said, okay. So now we could write the world's most expensive book. So that's what happened to me. When they said, you can't do it, I said, I have to do it then.
So, because of that, I'll move on to the casting. I was very impressed by that you did choose Meena Ji. I'd like to know a little bit about that. But you also chose for Chutki's role. You have seen the film, so you chose someone who's not trained and someone who's never done a movie before. Was that a conscious decision to pick a child who had such an important role in the film, who's never worked in a film?
I went to a school for audition. I auditioned, for the record, I auditioned 1,800 children. For the little girl's role. It's not easy to audition when you live in New York. You have to get agents. You go to Bombay and they show you all the kids who look, who are very fair, blue-eyed, and they have nail polishes, and they say, we all have YouTube channels, we can all dance like Kareena Kapoor, and that's not the girl I wanted, because she's inspired by a real-life girl who was walking on the road. So I go to this school, where my foundation works a lot in that school. We go to the school and they said, we have small drama society, would you like to see it? I'm like, no. So we went to a classroom with the kids, girls are very active, age group, 10 years old. And this girl, whom we're going to see in the movie, was totally worst audition because she was hungry. And she said, I could hear her, she said, Master Chef is coming, didn't bring any food to us. How do we know he's a Master Chef? I'm like, who said that? You see that girl in the back, the teacher says, don't take her, she's terrible. I said, how she can study, she's saying number one, but she beats the shit out of boys here. You don't listen to anyone. I go to her house, the parents are saying, take some, like she's very difficult to work with, but she was so amazing. And the thing was not just acting for 3 months, she was auditioned, 3 months we made her act. She was so trained to sell flowers on the river banks of Ganga. She became so trained, she'd tell them all the fake stories. She was so intelligent. And then later, she had to learn how to walk on the rope, which was the hardest part, which took us many more months.
I've had a quick question on, since you're the writer, story writer, and you've also done screenplay, and you've done the dialogues also. For filmmakers like myself, how does that, you know, how does it translate from, let's say, from a story? How easy was that? How does it translate?
Pain. Pain is a good thing. My father passed away suddenly and then started the whole change of world around me. Everybody had their backs towards me. And I was hiding in Varanasi, just didn't want to face the world. And I was lying down on the boat. I did the music of the movie. And I hummed something. So, sometimes the heart in pain doesn't sleep. It's very alert. You become very conscious of everything around you. I hum something so that now you're the audience. We can tell them how the music came about. So I hum this. And my boatsman, he said, that's Mother Ganges singing her son a lullaby. Oh, that was the most beautiful Nirvana moment I had. I went to California, I got this guy in Hollywood, and he started doing the music. And that's the tune which became the background tune. Don't depend on anyone when you want to make a movie. No one in this world who says they are talented are important. They're not. People lie too much that I am very talented, I am very good in my work, I work with so and so, and I'm self-entitled. You know who's important? Dedication. So you've done movies, so you know it. There's no one else feels for that movie, that's you. You can get the best babysitter, but what a grandmom can tell a story to a child, it will stay till the child goes in the grave. Not, it's always true. It has been true like this. So, I felt that nobody's feeling that story so much. So I said, okay, let me do it. And I remember when I was doing went for the movie, the guy said, we booked the studio, you want to record something. Who in the hell is music director? And I'm sitting on the table Googling, what is the job profile of music director? I said, I'm the music director because no one else is. So you don't have to depend. You need if you have the heart to tell the story, you're going to find a way to tell the story. You just need to jump on this.
We have similar experience now.
We're working on half the road. A lot of things. It's such a beautiful story. Half it was, I love it. Thank you so much for giving birth to this daughter. She's a real artist. And then after watching the and now because you know I have restaurants coming up, new restaurants, big investments. So I'm a little tired of going to film festivals because this is not a real thing. And suddenly there are 60 film festivals around the world. And we received some of it. But when Razia called me after watching the movie, I don't know, something happened to me. I felt that she felt the same pain what I was going through when I was making it and I was watching it. I told her on the phone, then I have someone in the room. I said, you know, Kavita and Razia, I'm going to sit between you and we're going to watch this movie together. That was the only thing. You have no idea how my life was last 3 days, jumping from country to country. And I said, no, I have to be in Boston on 13th. It's very important because that voice, because, you know, eventually as artists, if your art resonates with someone, you feel it reached home. You feel that art had landed safely. It's like giving birth to the child. Nobody knows the pain, but when the child lands perfectly, and you see that mother, you feel...
More like a dialogue.
Yeah, it's just dialogue. The entire movie is just a dialogue between a widow and an untouchable child. But when Kavita read it, the entire movie became like a poetry to me. I was not proud of the movie because I didn't know what I'd created. But from her mouth, it made me feel that I might have done something significant. And now I'm the global ambassadors for Global Widows Funds around the world, bringing reform in this widow's life.
I just have one last question, two last, and we'll just answer them together.
And then we'll do Q&A after watching
yes,
the movie.
Yes, we want to hear from you guys. One is that between you're a writer as well as a cook and a filmmaker also, of the three, which one brings you more joy?
I love doing things which people think it's strange. Something has happened to me. I've become a bigger rebel now. I think after my dad, I have no limitations because dad would keep a check on me. No, it's just mom living in Amritsar, doesn't know exactly what I'm doing. She's happy I call her every day twice when she wakes up and when she goes to sleep. I just feel I need to choose stuff which is more meaningful. You've done a lot for money and you've done a lot to project yourself and you know how we are. I don't want to be comfortable. I don't want to be that guy. Like my cousins, they were all so comfortable. And I just want to be that one who's uncomfortable because you feel that you have more power to create now than ever before. And these stories are more important. If you look at this movie, everything is symbolic. Everyone in this room is walking on a tightrope, balancing professional, emotional, like life between finances and projection ourselves. We are all wearing veils. And just walking on the tightrope so that the veil doesn't come off. We have adopted fake accents, fake names, so that we are walking on the rope, that we don't fall off. So I felt the walking on the rope was such a symbolic thing. And then today, what's going on in America, I think color is something which is extremely symbolic. And suddenly you start hearing people telling me, but he is a brown guy. How did he get a Michelin star? It's like, guys, I need to keep quiet, but I need to have that exit somewhere. So this is how this came as an exit to me.
What next?
On September 22nd, my new restaurant is opening in Dubai. Some people are dating it as one of the most anticipated.
It's Kinara.
I was shooting for this movie and Kinara name struck me the most because we all start our journeys from a Kinara. We all come to end our journeys at the Kinara. So I thought Kinara is the resting place. It's the place we're all searching for, something to hold on to. So we named the restaurant Kinara. And then we have some amazing books, streamlined. But I'm proud that, you know, from where I come from, we don't get opportunities like this. We don't get to be on the stage. It's a rare universal equation which got me so far. Without being too bright, and I know that, don't understand many things, but just staying to, that's what I said. Thank you very much. Thank you, Razia. Thank you for that phone call when I was in Toronto. That means a lot. She promised me she's going to bring her parents, but this is also, they're both here in the audience, which means a lot. Razia and Kavita came to pick me up from the airport, means a lot.
I think this is not, yeah, the picture is starting, and a lot of people have a lot of questions, which we'll take towards the end of the film. Thank you so much.